So today we have a good news at Prismic Studio for those that who like to use Prismic and Gatsby. Is the fact that we have the plugin ready. It's ready. Sure, this time.
It's ready this time. So yeah, we developed a new plugin for Gatsby in partnership with Birkir, which is the tech director at Ueno. And so this plugin is really useful to make the previews work with Prismic.
Right. So this it took us quite some time.
Yeah.
And we really wanted previews and edit button to work. And that's part because of we see these features are very important, not only because they are Prismic features, but, you know, the fact that you can preview in real time. You know, imagine editor. You have editors and, you know, they're working. We see the process as having, you know, editor having, you know, a laptop working on content, but in the same time having another screen that shows how it looks on the website and even maybe the mobile, and, you know, you're typing a title. Oh, it's too long on mobile. I should make it shorter. It's a good experience, right? And then the edit button, which is a thing that a button that you can click. And it shows you from your website what you need, which documents you need to go to when you have to edit things. And that's why we worked a lot on the plugin to make sure that these two functionalities work.
Yeah, because the issue with Gatsby is the fact that it's a static site generator. And so the concept of previews is only dynamic. Each time you make a new changes in the writing room, you need to update the content on your website. So to do that, you need to fetch the content asynchronously directly from Prismic instead of the main concept of Gatsby, which is getting the data locally in JavaScript files, basically. And everything is generated at build time.
Right.
That's the issue with Gatsby.
And then, but Gatsby, they got out their preview feature. Yeah. That we considered, but we found that it doesn't fit what we want to do.
By design, the preview feature of Gatsby is meant to work with only one preview at a time. So it's kind of an issue with Prismic because we have, for instance, shared preview. So you can share many previews to different people, and you can also have the preview from the writing room to preview your content. So we cannot handle only one preview at a time.
We want to handle different previews. Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
And also, we need the edit button to work. And that also, for edit button to be able to make it function, we need to have this kind of dynamism.
Yes. Yeah.
So how can you turn Gatsby from being statically generated to something dynamic that fetches data dynamically instead?
So basically, we found the trick to retrieve the query, the GraphQL query. We retrieve this query and we expose it to the component. And so when you run your project at runtime, we have some kind of wrapper around your component, which fetch the content directly from Prismic and merge the data that you have locally on Gatsby with the dynamic data. So we are able to just display the preview content.
So basically, the way I understand it, the website will run normally.
Yeah.
Without being dynamic at all?
Everything will be static. Only when you have a preview cookie from Prismic, it will fetch the data asynchronously. Otherwise, right. It will just get the content locally from the Gatsby files.
So users will not be impacted by
that? They won't be impacted. Only the people who are working on the website and which are connected to Prismic. That's pretty much it. Also, the syntax will remain exactly the same, so you won't have any impact on your code. And you can just install the plugin, and that's it. You are able to use the previews.
And when is this available?
It's already available. It's pushed on GitHub, it's released, so everything is working, and we have a demo for that. So we're gonna share this demo in this video in the description.
Cool, that's great. Well, thank you, Arno.
Awesome, thank you, Sadek.